Time and space as we know it started with a bang. What did the early universe look like immediately after the Big Bang? And how did that lead to us? I'm Leilan from ESA Education, and we're at the European Space Agency's Technical Center in the Netherlands to learn more about our cosmic history. From the Big Bang to the early stars and galaxies, we need to speak to an astronomer to find out more. Hi.
Hi, hello. My name is Rachana Bhatawdekar. I am a research fellow here at ESA. And before I started working at ESA, I did a PhD in astronomy from the University of Nottingham back in the UK. And even before that, I'm an engineer originally.
So you're an astronomer engineer. It sounds like the perfect person to ask about the early universe. So can you tell us what the early universe looked like?
Sure. So our universe formed in an event or in an explosion known as the Big Bang some 13.8 billion years ago. And just within a second after that, the universe was filled with small particles such as the electrons, protons, and neutrons. But because the universe was an unimaginably hot place right after the Big Bang, it was not possible for these particles to actually come together to form atoms. But then the universe continued to expand and cool down such that after about 400,000 years, when the temperature had dropped down to about 3,000 degrees, it became possible for these particles to come together to form neutral atoms, atoms of hydrogen and helium. And these hydrogen and helium, they were the first elements to form in the universe.
So when did the first stars and galaxies come to be?
So right after these very first elements, that is hydrogen and helium, were formed, there was a period in the history of our universe, something that we astronomers refer to as dark ages. And as the name suggests, I mean, the reason we call these period as dark ages is because there was essentially no source of light. The first stars and first galaxies, they were not born yet. And so the universe was predominantly composed of these dark clouds of hydrogen and helium. And so these dark ages lasted for about 100 million years or so. And only after that, the small dense clouds of hydrogen and helium, they started collapsing under the influence of their own gravity, becoming hot enough to kind of trigger the nuclear fusion reactions within them. And this led to the formation of the very first stars and first galaxies. So nuclear fusion essentially is that when two lightweight atoms are forced together to form a heavier atom, and a lot of energy is produced as a result.
And that energy is the light that we see.
Exactly. That is the light and the heat that we see from our own sun. That is exactly how it is formed.
We've often heard this expression that we are all made of stardust. How's that possible?
The light and the heat that we see from our sun, it is made through a process called as nuclear fusion. And all the elements that make up our human body, such as oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, and sulfur, they were created in stars through the very same process of nuclear fusion. At the end of their lives, stars swell up, they expand, and they explode in massive cosmic explosions known as supernova. And when supernova explode, they expel all the material they have produced, including the very elements that make up our own planet and even us. So essentially, because we, all of us, are carrying the remnants of these distant massive supernova explosions within our own bodies, we say that we are made of stardust.
The James Webb Space Telescope is often referred to as a time machine. How's that possible? How can it transport us so far back in time?
Because light takes time to travel from one place to another, we see objects not as they are now, but as they were when they emitted the light that has traveled across the universe to us. So for example, the light from the sun takes about 8 minutes to reach us. So when we are looking at sun, we are looking at it not as it is now, but as it was 8 minutes ago. Similarly, the nearest neighboring galaxy, Andromeda, it is 2.5 million light years away. So when we are looking at Andromeda, we are looking at it as it was 2.5 million years ago. So essentially all the telescopes are time machines, but the James Webb Space Telescope, or the JWST, it's going to take us the furthest back yet. So if I have to put things in perspective, the Hubble Space Telescope that we have now, it is the most powerful telescope, and with it we have been able to discover galaxies as far back as 13.4 billion years ago. This was when the universe was just 400 million years old. But the James Webb Space Telescope, it has been designed to peer the universe even further than that, to find the first stars and first galaxies when the universe was just 200 million years old.
So we're talking about baby photos of the early universe.
Baby photos of the early universe, precisely. Yeah.
Cool. When it comes to stars and galaxies, which one came first? Do we know?
We don't know that yet. All we know that is the very first sources of light, they came after the Dark Ages, as I explained earlier. So about 150 million years after the Big Bang. So yeah, I'm very much excited and looking forward to work on the data from JWST very soon.
Yeah, we hope to could see it soon as well.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah. Thank you so much for speaking to us today.
No problem. This was so much fun. Thank you so much.